The Lakers have made a decision on the future of general manager Rob Pelinka. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and come join us over on Playback during every single Lakers game. Come watch the Lakers directly with us. Chat with us while we watch the Lakers in action. So according to Chris Haynes of Yahoo, the Lakers have reached an agreement on a contract extension with general manager Rob Pelinka. ESPN's Dave McMenamin adding that this extension was actually reached a while ago when the Lakers actually signed on Darvin Ham. We're just now hearing about this, which is a little peculiar. I'm not sure why it took so long to actually hear that this extension had been reached, but whatever the case, Rob Pelinka will be the head of the Lakers front office for the next 4 years. Haynes added that the Lakers believe very strongly that the general manager job and the head coach need to be aligned. They feel like they have that with Rob Pelinka and Darvin Ham, and so they are committing to the two of them together for the next 4 years. Again, you've got Darvin Ham as the head coach, Rob Pelinka as the head of the front office, working side by side to build out the next generation of this team. Because let's face it, on a four-year contract, most likely we're talking about the end of the LeBron era. So Rob Pelinka will be running the front office all the way through the remainder of LeBron's tenure with the Lakers. Remember, he has 2 years left under contract. Then he has a player option for another year. Same thing with Anthony Davis. So it's potentially 2 years left with LeBron James. Maybe it's three, depending on what he does with that player option. Again, same thing with Anthony Davis, but pretty strong likelihood that Rob Pelinka will now be in charge of the front office through the remainder of LeBron's Lakers tenure and after. That means he'll be around to start a Lakers rebuild, to figure out the next iteration of the Los Angeles Lakers as well. So that's a pretty strong commitment from the Lakers to meet to Rob Pelinka. And it's a little bit strange when we look at it in the context of what happened last season. I've said it many times. Last season was the worst season in Lakers history relative to fan expectations, in terms of fan experience. That was brutal. That season was so, so difficult. And in fact, Frank Vogel, the head coach, lost his job. That's how bad the season was. And yet when you look at the roster, I think it's fair to say, well, Frank Vogel was not blameless. I think it's fair to say that the bigger problem than the head coach was roster construction, and that falls on the front office. It was the Russell Westbrook trade being part of that puzzle as well. And again, as much as you can say, well, LeBron, Anthony Davis, Clutch Sports, all of this is mixed in. Look, there's plenty of blame to go around, but ultimately the construction of the roster comes down to the front office. Frank Vogel loses his job. Rob Pelinka gets an extension. Not only doesn't lose his job, he gets an extension on his contract after the worst season in team history. Now, that's the negative side of things. It's not all negative, I promise. It's not. But that is the part of it that I think will cause Lakers Nation, Lakers fans to raise their eyebrows a little bit at this, about how this is going on. Because in terms of context, a little bit peculiar that that's what's happening here. Rob Pelinka gets the extension coming off of that particular season. However, the positive spin, look, we've been hearing all summer about Russell Westbrook trades, about the urgency to try to fix this roster, all of that. Well, the Lakers have done things to try to reduce that pressure to improve the roster immediately. And I think they've learned from recent history, what happens when there's pressure on a general manager, when there's pressure on a front office, is it's an environment where bad deals can happen. And yes, I'm referencing Jimmy Buss and Mitch Kupchak signing Luol Deng and Timofey Mozgov. There was so much pressure to improve the team immediately. Otherwise, they were going to lose their jobs. They went and made a couple of really terrible signings to the point where Jeannie Buss wound up removing them from power just before the trade deadline because she was worried they were going to do something else, some other trade that was going to hurt the franchise for the future in an effort to try to save their jobs. Well, the Lakers don't want to be in that situation. They don't want a key decision maker like Rob Pelinka to feel that pressure and to have that leverage placed over him by other franchises who are going to take the approach of Rob Pelinka needs to make a trade in order to save his job, so we're going to fleece him. We've seen it this summer. The Indiana Pacers would not budge. They wanted both first-round picks unprotected, 2027 and 2029, unprotected, along with Russell Westbrook in exchange for Buddy Hield and Miles Turner. They wouldn't consider second-round picks instead of one of those firsts. They wouldn't consider sending back some second-round draft compensation. Nope. They drew the line in the sand and said, this is what we want or no deal, period. They played hardball with the Lakers. How much of that is because they felt like the Lakers and Rob Pelinka were desperate? So the positive spin on this is now teams negotiating. Now this is public. Teams negotiating with the Lakers, with Rob Pelinka. They know now that he doesn't have to make a move in order to save his job. That pressure has been completely removed from him. The Lakers have committed to him. They've said, you are our guy, and we believe in you. Now, I know some Lakers fans will disagree with that decision, but that's the positive side of doing this now, is that it allows Rob Pelinka to go into trade negotiations and not have that sense of urgency that he has to do something in order to save his own job. Instead, he can worry solely about what is best for the future of this franchise. And again, the Lakers have committed to him and said, you will be a part of this future. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Is this the right decision to hand the reins over to Rob Pelinka for the foreseeable future? 4 years is a lifetime in the NBA. Is this the right thing for the Lakers to do? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section. Don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.